this evening.
Everybody's here.
Well, that's great. Yeah, it's,
yep, you bet.
And Tom, this is your home, and we are our homeboy. And what do you think of this little gathering? Oh, this is tremendous. I know this has been going on for 7 years, and this is Gavin and Jerry. I mean, with people from Long Beach has put this together, and this is fantastic. And especially I'm from here, and I saw a lot of people that I grew up with today, and the line is coming along. And we shot the two hot wheel troops down here, which are great. And he's really been a great trooper today. So, signed a lot of autographs and saw a lot of people and really had a good time. So this upcoming movie that's coming between you two, give the folks just a little oversight of the essence of the movie.
Well, it's called the St. Mongoose movie, and it's supposed to be out next summer. And I spent 33 days a lot of the time on the set, and he was like a director, you know. It's him and Fred Breyer was here. They were, you know, showing everything. And Don remembered a lot of stuff, and he got in a couple of the cars. He started up the car, black and brown car, and he got it in his hot wheel, you know, his pretty car, and burned out and had him a good time. And so hopefully the movie's going to be good. Everyone's going to enjoy it and have a fun time watching.
Now, this movie is not just about drag racing. It's about the relationship and your family's involvement in it as well, isn't it, Don?
Yeah, that's right. It's not just a drag racing movie. It's a movie about a story about two guys that came from opposite of the track, so to speak. And they met up at Clyde's Drag Strip. And they went on to pick up this nickname, Snake and Mongoose. And one of the guys had a great idea about going to tell for sponsorship. So after the sponsorship, Greed took over. And we started racing each other and battling and so on, but his kid actually came down with a disease called leukemia, and he passed away. And along the storyline, Tom beat me at the last race of the year at the U.S. Nationals, which is a true story. And so it's a real feel-good movie at the end. And it's quite touching. We watched him film it, and he brought a tear to my eye from time to time.
Well, I'm sure it's going to bring tears to a lot of people because they all remember watching you two racing at Lions. I had the pleasure of taking your photographs every Saturday night. How many people out there saw these two boys at Lions? Look at all those hands. No one you're popular today. So it's obviously going to be a very family-oriented as well as the racers.
Well, it's best, yeah, most of it until McEwen's part in there, because he started running out of the girlfriends. But no, it really is. I kid him about that. But I tell you, it's pretty damn good. I got to tell you, these actors, get to play my part. His name's Jesse Williams. He's a doctor on Grey's Anatomy. And a kid by the name of Richard Blake played the Mongoose. They're both good actors. It's pretty cool. I mean, a lot of these stars, I want to thank a lot of these guys that participated in the movie that's here. Everybody but Mike Cole, we couldn't get him out there. He made too much money. But anyhow, we had a great time doing the movie. And I want to really thank these folks for bringing their cars out and being part of the movie.
Well, they love doing it. Now, Fred Dreyer, is he? Fred, come down. Fred Dreyer, where are you hiding? Now, you all remember Fred from the LA Rams, Hunter. Well, he plays Ed Donovan in the movie. And those of you who knew Ed Donovan, this is was an interesting casting job. Mr. Dreyer, where are you hiding? Is he back there? All right, here he, come on, Fred. Come on out here and see the fans. I know you either were a LA Ram fan or a Hunter fan when you were growing up.
So how good a job did he play playing that darn?
Well, Bob, Ron and I brought him in the morning because we thought he's an old friend of ours. We thought he'd be great in the morning. And I had him in for one scene in one day. And he was so good, they kept me for half the movie. Ladies and gentlemen, Fred Dreyer. So, Fred, how was it to play Ed Donovan in the movie?
Well, Tom had me come in to save the movie. I think I did that. I think if the day you see that, Don and Tom, great hosts, I enjoyed it tremendously. I did it because this is a rare movie, a rare opportunity for people to see the history of drag racing, to understand that these two guys is really astounding. As time has gone on, these guys are the icons of this sport.
And Fred wasn't just recruited for this movie because he's been around drag racing a long time. In fact, we did discuss the pyramid meeting at Bill Simpson's shop back. Yes. One of the first meetings, Mr. Donovan. The new Mr. Donovan. So, how did you prepare for the role to play Ed Donovan?
I got drunk for about 2 weeks.
Right on, brother.
I met Ed Donovan a long time ago. And he is also a tremendous individual and a great icon of this sport. He's great friends with Don and Tom. I have a great deal of respect for the people I worked with, the people I met along the way. And Ed was one of those people. Unfortunately, he's not here to share it. And I guess the polar opposites of that.
What was Kathy's response when you found out Fred was playing her dad?
I don't know. I have to ask Don.
Yeah, we talked to her and she was thrilled to death and that he would be honored in the movie and thought great Fred playing him was great. And Don and I, she could hardly wait to get involved if they waited. She wants to come see it, so she was real happy with the thing. And remember that Donovan's the one that got the Mongoose. Don was already called the Snake, and for his lightning reflexes, he tells me. And Donovan, I was riding for Donovan, and we were lucky enough to meet him a couple times. He didn't get beat very often those days. And Donovan says, this is like Mongoose in the Snake movie. You should be the Mongoose. He's already the Snakes. So that's what we started that. He's actually the one that named me the Mongoose. So it goes back quite a ways on this thing. And then Fred comes in and does that in the movie as the Donovan guy.
Well, I think the trick was that Tom wanted to be the Snake, but that name was taken, so he settled for the Mongoose.
Is there any truth to that?
You see, you bring a guy out of the mothballs and nobody remembers where he went to Hollywood for 25 years. I tried to bring his career back and this time he talks about it.
You know, I think the outtakes of this movie would probably be a big hit. I mean, a huge hit. So I hope she sees it comes out after the fact with the outtakes of this movie because they got to be classic, wouldn't it? What was it like working with these kind of guys as opposed to like real actors?
You hope for professionalism going in, but you've got to settle for a little bit less with these two guys.
It was
absolutely great. Everybody was terrific, and Don and Tom added an awful lot to it, and they made the movie better because you know they hired a British actor, a British director to direct all that, and so he was a little behind the curve on. American drag racing, certainly Southern California drag racing, a seat of drag racing. So Don and Tom had to refresh his memory a little bit, and everything was fine.
That's what I'm talking about when the drag line came into play.
Fred didn't think the director was worth nothing. So he's telling every day, he's telling the director, he don't know what he's doing. So Fred kind of half-assed directed the movie, I think.
Well, he had some experience telling what to do. All she told his experience was arguing with track owners to get paid, right? Because I don't know how much is similarity to that. So I did hear you had to step in a bit and straighten out. Give us an example of a scene that they had completely wrong that you had to write. You know what I'm saying? The scene that was like, no, the people will laugh if you do that.
Well, I think that happens in all movies, you know, and especially in a movie like this, that they kind of veered off from the
real story, and so they could more appeal to their thinking. But we wanted to make sure that the drag racers and the folks that understand the sport and understand us, and know about us, and the real story was told. So we, you know, they had to reshoot a new scene, and I was hell-bent on them doing it. And I think it's a lot better, and it represents what we're really doing. But those things happen. I think the big deal is that I think the folks are going to really, really like it. They're going to really relate to it. And they're going to really understand there's a lot more to us than just going out and getting the sponsor and going racing. It took a whole lot of hard work, and these two characters are playing our part. I think nailed it at all.
Most people actually think you guys were mad at each other all the time, and the more madder they appeared, the more money they made, correct?
Well, we still don't like each other.
Because he's better looking, or what?
Well, I want to tell all the girls that he actually praised himself in the nude scenes in the movie.
Fred, you didn't have to stand in the middle and watch this, did you?
Well, I did a lot of fun doing the pavement in there, too.
To watch these two. I'm telling you, the outtakes would be a hit. Huge hit.
Hey, guys.
Oh, we got some photo op. You guys get in?
Let's start them up, man. Let's
We're going to auction off these. Okay, couple shot. There you go, guys. Hey,
you got more cameras than
You guys would think these guys are Hollywood stars.
It's like Indy 500.
You know? Okay, now you guys, all right, wait a minute.
Academy Awards stuff.
Okay, all you people have gotten to see is you guys turn around and wave to these people. They've been looking at your backs. There you go. All right, I guess we're going to get this program going a little bit. And guys, thanks for coming and talking. We're sure looking forward to seeing that thing again. They're going to be here. They've got, a souvenir. You guys going to still open over there? Tom, you still open?